The structure and function of the cardiovascular system. Our cardiovascular system circulates blood through our bodies, supplying oxygen and nutrients. The heart is like a pump that drives blood circulation. The blood vessels are the distribution system. They comprise arteries and veins. The arteries carry oxygen-rich blood from the heart into the body, where the oxygen is transferred to the cells. The oxygen-poor blood is carried back to the heart by the veins. The heart pumps low-oxygen blood from the veins into the lungs. The blood is enriched with oxygen again in the lungs. The oxygen-enriched blood is then carried back to the heart. The heart pumps the oxygen-rich blood back into the body and the cycle begins again. The heart is divided into two sides, labeled right and left from the perspective opposite the viewer. The right and left sides of the heart each have two chambers, the atrium and the ventricle. The ventricles have powerful muscles that pump the blood through the circulatory system. To keep the blood flowing in the right direction, there are one-way valves at the entrance and exit of each ventricle, the heart valves. The entrance to the right ventricle is through the tricuspid valve. The exit is through the pulmonary valve. The entrance to the left ventricle is through the mitral valve. The exit is through the aortic valve. Every time the ventricle muscles contract, blood is pumped into the circulatory system. During this time, the pulmonary and aortic valves are kept open and the tricuspid and mitral valves are kept closed. During the relaxation phase, the ventricles fill with blood. At this time, the mitral and tricuspid valves are open and the aortic and pulmonary valves are closed. With every filling and ejection phase, the heart valves ensure the blood is pumped into the body's circulatory system. This way, the heart drives the bloodstream and supplies the cells of our bodies with oxygen and nutrients continuously.